parents, how do we grow our children to become independent individuals? So to discuss that, I would like us first to define independence. When we think about independent children, we think about children who get dressed themselves, who maybe brush their teeth themselves, maybe even do it well enough. We think about children who, who willingly do their homework when they come from school, children who clear the table, who help around the house. That's what we think when we think of independent children. But what do we think about when we think about independent adults? Wow, something totally different. When I think of an independent adult, and I'll admit I took a while to define it, for me, an independent adult is somebody who knows exactly what he wants. He knows what he needs to do to get there. He's not afraid to start the journey once and again. He knows that he can fail. He knows that he can fall, and he knows that he will have the strength to stand up and try again. This is what I define an independent adult. These are the people who will get places in their lives because they know how it feels to get to places. And when people feel good, they are encouraged to do good and do better. So how do we make that switch? How do we make the switch from getting dressed and brushing teeth and doing homework to actually becoming that individual, adult individual I just described, who is ready to take on the world? Well, the first thing that we would like to do is to teach our children to recognize their needs and to teach them that recognizing their needs makes them feel nice and pleasant. Because, guys, independence is a need. It is not something we can teach. It is not something that we can force. It is an existential human need that everybody, that humanity has been fighting for since the days of Genesis. Think about it. All the wars we have around the world have to do with freedom and independence. We need it. We strive for it. We seek it. Whether us parents are going to aid it or not, whether we're going to help or not, our children are going to seek their independence. Now, it might not be the independence, the exact sort of independence we hope for, but isn't that what independence is about? Independent from us, doing what they want. And for that, we have to start really, really early. Now, my favorite example for this is drop-off or pick-up at school at winter. You see all these children fighting to not put their coats on. Like, it's cold, and we have all these kids screaming, "I'm not cold, I don't want to put it on," and all their loving mothers are forcing these jackets on. What's happening there? I mean, being cold doesn't meet anyone's needs. It doesn't feel nice. Nobody really likes being cold. So what is it? That is the need for autonomy. Children who have been told that they are cold and they should be wearing their jackets right now, since the day they were born, develop a power struggle with cold. They develop a power struggle with the jacket, and they develop a power struggle with their mothers. Because, again, nobody likes to be cold. And when we say, okay, you know what, honey, don't put your jacket on, just let me know when you get cold, we teach our child that it is absolutely okay to tell us what he needs and feels. And we teach our child that it's okay to change your mind. And we teach our child that we will be there right next to him and helping him whenever he decides that he is now cold. On the other hand, when we force him to put the jacket on, we teach him that there will always be somebody there who knows better than him what he wants and what he needs. And we also teach him that his voice is not going to be sound because our voice matters more. Now, we don't really think about it in these terms, but every single word we say to a child teaches a child a certain lesson. But more often than not, it is not the lesson that we want our child to learn. So instead of speaking so much and trying to teach all these lessons actively, let's listen more and be a bit more calm about everything. Our children know what they want. They know what they need. They need their independence to come from themselves. They need their independence to come from another need, the need for belonging, the need for acceptance, the need to be part of something bigger, their family. They have a need to resemble to us because it makes them feel good to be one of the same together with the people who love them most. So we don't need to teach them to clear the table. We don't need to teach them to put their toys away. We don't need to do any of that. We need to do it and ask them to help and trust them that they will help next time. And in a couple of other times, they will do it themselves. Why? Because it will come from within. And guys, it works. I know it might sound like this long lost dream, but it works because kids need their independence. You can't force it, you can't teach it, but you can encourage it using kind words. If we tell them time and again that we are there for them right now if they're not ready, but we are absolutely certain that once they are ready, they will do it themselves, that they will come and they will be ready. On the other hand, if we keep saying things like, why can't you ever do anything yourself? Why can't you just do this or that? What did I ask you to do? If we tell them those things, they will learn that we don't trust them. And they probably won't do those things that we want them to do so badly. So instead of pushing for this independence, let it come from within.